Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick here in the United States. Lots of people ask me, they want to be filled with the Holy Spirit. They want to be used by God. Thank the Lord, some people. I just met with Brother Sid. He's the moderator of the overseas, the online church, Church of the Firstborn. If you go below this, all of my videos, if you go to the says see more, you click on that, there's a link there, churchfirstborn.com. If you have prayer requests, please send them to us. If you would like to be involved in our online church as a prayer warrior, and different, we got all different kinds of things. And the Lord gave us that online church and told us to set it up. And now that I'm in the States, we're going to start doing more things through that, brothers and sisters. So as the Lord would lead and guide. But brothers and sisters, I just want to tell you, Brother Sid, and the reason why I mentioned Brother Sid, because I just saw him. We just met Tuesday evening, and we've met a few times in the past and talked several times on the phone and whatnot. Brother Sid said that he was one of the 1%. And I said, what do you mean, Brother Sid? He said, well, like you said in the video you made the other day, there's only, a few people who want to be used by God. And I was mentioning in some videos I've made in the past and the other day that I preached in hundreds of places, brothers and sisters, and lots of times when I'm preaching to Christians, not evangelism, done lots of evangelistic crusades, but then I've done revivals, and I always say, anybody want to be used by the Lord, in signs and wonders, to evangelize, to go be a missionary, whatever, et cetera, to be used by God, to bring glory to His name, to be closer to the Lord. I said just 1% of the people would come forward and say, yes, I want you to pray for me, Brother Patrick, that the Lord would use me. Make me the next Billy Graham or whatever, the next Apostle Paul. And Brother Sid said he was one of those people. And I praise the living God for that, brothers and sisters. And so for those of you who watch my videos, it takes people who are more mature in the faith to watch my videos, because I do discipleship and teaching, go in the deep things of God, and not just, just evangelism. Lots of churches who, if they do still preach the word, there's very few of them. And the ones that do, of course, it's mostly evangelism. But praise be to God, for whatever reason, God chose me that He wanted to use me to do this, more of a discipleship. But brothers and sisters, that's what I'm making this video about. For those who want to be used by God. The Lord just told me tonight while I was praying. And this is the secret. This is what He wanted me to tell you. If you want to be used by God, you got to celebrate Jesus. You got to exalt Jesus. You got to worship Jesus. I mean, it's just that simple. I could give you an hour-long video about it. But the bottom line, if you exalt the Lord and lift Him up, He will draw all men unto Him, He said. He said, if I be lifted up, I will draw all men unto me. If you're going to give glory to the Lord, worship the Lord, seek the Lord Jesus Christ, call upon His name. There's so many songs. I'm going to put a link to a song down here that the Lord gave me. It's a hill song that the Lord gave me to go along with this message. I'm going to put the link on here on the video, or I need to put it underneath, I guess. I've been having, it's hard. If I put a bubble on here, it's not an active link. There's some way of doing it. But anyway, brothers and sisters, God bless you guys. I want to pray for you guys, brothers and sisters. I want you, every one of you, to experience, the anointing of the Lord. Now, when I'm going to pray for you, and I pray for people lots of times on videos, you're experiencing my anointing and my flow with the Lord. And that's people who don't have the anointing, they don't understand these things. I can go into a church, and not just me, anyone that's a spirit-filled Christian, can go into any church, brothers and sisters, or listen to any video, and they can feel the anointing of that person. And it's not always true, 100%, but generally speaking, that person's relationship and how much time they spend in reading the Bible and praying and worshiping the Lord and how pure their motive is for the Lord, the greater their anointing is. You can feel it. You can discern it. Now, that's discernment of spirits. You can feel it in your spirit. If someone who's up there singing in a church is only performing, they're unanointed or they're very anointed, but they're performing, you know, or they're performing for the Lord and not for man. You know, you can discern and feel these things at different levels, brothers and sisters, in our spirit. Our spirit bears witness with the spirit that is in them, flowing, the Holy Spirit, and feeling these things, brothers and sisters. So you can have your own anointing, your own feeling of the Lord. And God gives various anointings based on what you're called to do. God calls you to be an evangelist, He's going to anoint you to be an evangelist. If He calls you to be a missionary, you know, to go out and plant churches and, you know, really do an apostolic work in an unreached area, then He's going to anoint you to do that. He's going to give you the wisdom to do it. He's going to give you the finances to do it. All the things needed to do whatever it is God calls you to do. Just like those orphanages that we built in the Philippines. You know, the Lord wanted me to do it as part of my ministry. God wanted those orphanages built. So He gave me the wisdom, the calling, the leading, the open doors, the anointing, the finances, everything to do that. He made a way. You know, like those old Don Moen songs, you know, God will make a way where there seems to be no way. He works it out in His own way. He will make a way for me. You know, God makes a way for us. Rivers in the desert, will we see? Heaven and earth may, you know, fade, but His word will still remain. Hallelujah. He will do something new today. God will make a way. Brothers and sisters, I want to pray for you. Like I said, the secret is that the Lord wanted me to tell you tonight in this video, the word from the Lord is celebrate Jesus. There's a song by Don Moen too, you know. Celebrate Jesus, celebrate. That's the song. And the song goes on to say, He is risen, He is risen. Come on and celebrate the resurrection of our Lord. That's what the Lord wants you to celebrate. Him, and that He has overcome the grave. He has conquered the grave. He has conquered the grave. Jesus has rose again. He has conquered the grave. It is finished. It is done. Thy kingdom come, Thy will be done in us as it is in heaven. Brothers and sisters, as I mentioned yesterday in the video, the Lord is reminding me to tell you that the Lord had been showing me all week about His people passing under the shepherd's rod. You know, I've heard a little bit about people. You know, there's a book. People write books, a yearly report of what God's going to do that year, the shepherd's rod. And I went and researched it a little bit, and this is for the Jewish people, the celebration from Rosh Hashanah, the days of all from the Jewish New Year until the Day of Atonement. Yom Kippur is the time when the Jewish people are saying in their traditions and understanding of what God's doing, that's the time that He is judging His people of what He will do in the new year with each person, brothers and sisters. We are not Jewish, as you know. I don't promote those things because those feasts are fulfilled in Christ. Jesus is the fulfillment of all things. The Word of God, as Jesus said, He said, search the Scriptures. In them you think you have eternal life, but those things that are written speak about Me. It's all about Jesus. Jesus is the Passover Lamb. He is our atonement. You know, the Feast of Trumpets is announcing His return for His bride, brothers and sisters. But anyway, brothers and sisters, anyway, this is a season because the Lord told me that He is looking at His people. He is looking at His people in this season. God does things in seasons. That's also true, brothers and sisters. Even though we are not under the law, those things are from God and there are meaning from God to His people. And we would do well to observe those things and glean from those things what would apply to us, the church. Now that's the word from the Lord to you. And the thing that the Lord wants you to do is to know that if as you're celebrating Him, the resurrection of the Lord, God is watching us and observing us, and He's going to pour out blessings that we cannot contain. Like I said, I've never taught this. This is what the Lord is showing me. And I can only say what the Lord is showing me. Brothers and sisters, God bless you. Blessing be the name of the Lord, for He is worthy of... How does it go? Blessed be the name of the Lord. He is worthy to be praised and adored. Hallelujah. As we lift up holy hands in one accord, blessed be the name. Blessed be the name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. The Lord has had me singing all these Don Moen songs tonight. I haven't listened to those since I first got saved, brothers and sisters. I first came back to the Lord in the year 2000. The first non-Baptist hymnal songs I ever heard was Don Moen. And I was like, I didn't know they had music that wasn't hymnals. I never thought about any music that was anointed or it wasn't a hymnal. I was like, man, this is awesome, man. They've got all kinds of music that Christians can listen to. This is cool. Anyway, brothers and sisters, that's what the Lord wants me to tell you. I'm going to pray for you. So I want you to sing, you know, blessed be the name of the Lord, for he is worthy to be praised and adored. Let's lift up hands in one accord. Singing, blessed be the name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. He is worthy to be praised and adored. Hallelujah. As we lift up hands in one accord, blessed be the name. Blessed be the name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Right now, I'm just going to pray for you guys, brothers and sisters. We can flow in the anointing together here and experience the Lord. The Lord wants me to tell you, he's going to send revival on his people because he wants us to be those sheep. As I was telling you earlier, and the Lord is just reminding me, I mentioned it yesterday in the video I made, that there's several verses, you can look them up, about the sheep passing under the shepherd's rod. But one of those things, one of those references to that is about how they would pick out that 10%, that tithe to give to the Lord, those without spot or blemish. Now, the Lord is coming for a bride without spot or blemish. Brothers and sisters, we need to prepare to meet the Lord for the rapture. The Lord has also gave me another text about when Joshua, you know, Moses representing the Old Testament. Moses was not allowed to go into the promised land. But Joshua, the same name that Jesus' Hebrew name and Joshua's Hebrew name is the same. Joshua, representing the Lord, led the children of Israel across the Jordan River, representing the second heaven, as I made a video a long time ago, leading them into the promised land. Just as the Lord will part the second heaven and push back all those the prince of Persia and all those powers and principalities that withstood Gabriel in the days of Daniel. God's going to part that just as he parted the River Jordan for the children of Israel to part, to cross over. Joshua will also be used by God. Of course, the Father, when Jesus descends from heaven with a shout, and the second heaven will be parted for us to go across into the promised land. Our brothers and sisters, in that text, it says, Joshua warned the people that we need to prepare against the third day. On the third day, we're going to cross. 3 days from hence, we will cross into the promised land. Same thing that Moses said, another type of the rapture when Moses went up. Then the Lord came down to meet him on top of the mountain. And Moses, God wanted to talk directly to the people and give them the Ten Commandments on the day of Pentecost, before there was a Pentecost. And the same thing Moses said, that God said through Moses to the children of Israel, prepare against the third day. Be prepared to go up and meet the Lord. So the third day, of course, Jesus was resurrected on the third day. Brothers and sisters, the real name for the rapture, you know, the rapture is the Latin word to be snatched up. But really, what is the rapture? It's the resurrection of the saints. The first resurrection, the holy resurrection of the saints, is the rapture. So Jesus was resurrected on the third day. The children of Israel went up to meet with God to get the Ten Commandments on the third day. Yeshua, son of Nun, led the children of Israel across the Jordan into the promised land on the third day. And every situation they were to prepare to be that bride without spot or blemish, to be ready to pass under the shepherd's rod, to be separated from the world. That other 90% of the sheep are sent out. They have spots and blemishes. They're not worthy to meet the Lord in the air with a shout. When he descends from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel and the trump of God. Brothers and sisters, the trump of God, that is what the Feast of Trumpets is all about, brothers and sisters. Blowing those trumpets, calling a solemn assembly to meet the church of the firstborn, to meet our Lord. Hebrews chapter 12. That's the place we're going to, Mount Zion, to the church of the firstborn, with the heavenly host, the heavenly angels, and even the Father himself, of course, is there, where the church of the firstborn will be. And what is Jesus the firstborn of? He's the firstborn born from the dead, the firstborn among many brethren, the firstborn of the resurrection, the first fruit of the resurrection. Brothers and sisters, that's what it's all about, that resurrection. Let's bless the Lord because He is worthy to be praised and adored. Blessed be the name of the Lord. We celebrate Jesus because we celebrate the resurrection. That's what Jesus did. He came. He died. You know, like there's another song. You lived. You died. You rose again on high. You showed us the way. That, you know, that we can live again. Hallelujah for what you've done. The Lord has done that for us. Look what the Lord has done. He healed our body. He cleared our mind. You know, He saved us just in time. Hallelujah. He rescued us. He redeemed us. Hallelujah. He has called us by our name and said, hey, Patrick, follow me. Hey, Gary, follow me. Hey, Minister Paul, follow me. All of you guys, I'm going to start calling all your names. You know, He called us by our name and said, hey, follow me. And He's going to do the same thing at the rapture. He's going to call you by name and say, you know, Joan, come up here. Come up here and I'll show you what's going to happen next. You see that door open in heaven and the Lord will be descending through that thing and it's going to be the trump of God and the shout. The Lord will shout, come up here, just like He does to the two witnesses, just like what He did to the Apostle John. He'll say, your name, come up here. He will call you to Himself. Come up here. Hallelujah. I can't wait to hear the Lord say, hey, Patrick, come up here. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord, here I am. Like Samuel did as a child. I'm going to pray for you right now. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. I just speak right now. I speak the blessings of your Holy Spirit, Lord God. It's not by might or by power, but by thy Spirit. Hallelujah. I speak that the Lord says, finish the race. Hallelujah, that is set before you. Hallelujah. Strengthen the feeble knees. Hallelujah. Have your feet straight. Hallelujah. Finish the race that is set before you. Hallelujah. Behold, the Lord is coming quickly. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And His reward is with Him. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. I release. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. All the river that is within me, I release that river of living water, Lord, upon your people, Lord God. Hallelujah. And I declare, He is worthy to be praised and adored. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. He is worthy to be praised and adored. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah. So we lift up holy hands in one accord, singing, blessed be the name. Yes, Lord. Blessed be the name. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Bless you, Lord Jesus. You are worthy. You are worthy of high praises. High praises. Lord, we lift your name on high, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 In the highest. Glory to God in the highest. Hallelujah. Blessings and honor and glory and praise be unto our Lord and our God. Hallelujah. Our Savior, our Deliverer, our Redeemer. Hallelujah. The Sovereign King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Worthy is His name. Hallowed be His name. Hallelujah. 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 He is worthy. He is worthy to be praised and adored. Hallelujah. 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 That wretched flesh like us, hallelujah, can be redeemed, can be saved, can be healed, can be cleansed, can be delivered. It's not by might nor by power, but by my Spirit, saith the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Out of the miry clay you have formed us, Lord, in your own image, Lord God. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah. You called us and cleansed us and redeemed us and saved us. Hallelujah. And delivered us, Lord. Hallelujah. From our sin, Lord Jesus. and from this earth, from this fallen world, Lord. Hallelujah. Victory is mine in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Well, I'm just going to sing as the Lord leads me. Victory is mine. Victory is mine. Victory today is mine. I told Satan, get thee behind. Victory today is ours. Victory is ours. Victory is ours. Victory today is ours. We told Satan, get thee behind. Victory today is ours. Hallelujah. Bless you, Lord my God. Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be his holy name, brothers and sisters. He is worthy to be praised and adored. You want to experience the anointing of God? Start lifting up Yeshua HaMashiach. Start glorifying and praising his name. Hallelujah. For the Bible says the Spirit of the Lord inhabits the praises of his people. Hallelujah. 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 God said, if you draw close to me, I'll draw close to you. Call upon me and I will answer you and show you great and mighty things that you know not. Hallelujah. No weapon that is formed against me and you shall prosper. Every tongue that rises up against us, thou shalt condemn. This is the inheritance of the saints of God, and their righteousness is of me, saith the Lord. Hallelujah. Blessings and honor and glory belong to our Lord and our God, for he has redeemed us. He has called us. He has set us apart to be his children, to be his chosen ones, to be his bride, a peculiar people, a holy nation, who were not a nation but are now a nation, to provoke those Israelites to jealousy, that they might come to the saving knowledge of the truth, that Yeshua HaMashiach is the Messiah. He's the Lord. He's the King of Kings. He's the Savior. He is the Messiah they've been waiting for. And the Lord himself shall suddenly appear in the temple, hallelujah, and reveal himself to his brethren, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. And we will be with him on that day, brothers and sisters. We will be with the Lord when he descends and comes back to this earth, brothers and sisters, to Bozrah, and to the Mount of Olives in Jerusalem, Lord. The Lord will reveal himself to his people, brothers and sisters. And we will return with him, even as Enoch, seventh from Adam, had prophesied. Hallelujah. That the Lord would return with 10,000s of his saints. Hallelujah. That's us, Lord, the Lord's bride. Hallelujah. And the Lord will bring us with him. And we will forever be with the Lord. From the moment of the rapture, forever we will be with the Lord. He's promised us. John chapter 14. I've went through many Bible verses, brothers and sisters, and I didn't give them. You can go Google them. Praise God that Google, even though there's lots of evil things, but Google can also be used to look up Bible verses with a few words. Praise be God. Praise be God. Praise be God forevermore. Jeremiah 33:3 was one of them. Isaiah 55:17, 54:17. Praise be to God, Most High, Creator of heaven and earth, who has redeemed us from the curse of the law. We've been set free. We've been redeemed. He has made us his chosen people. How great is it? How awesome is it that the creator of the universe would come and die for us? And that old demonic religion, Allah wants people to die for him in a jihad. But the Lord came, God came and died for us. Hallelujah. What kind of love and what manner of love is this? John asked. You know, that God would love us and save us and deliver us and let us become children of God. What manner of love is this that we can be called a child of God? You know, there's no better deal that's ever been made. Grace. There's never been a deal like this. All those millions and billions of people that rejected grace of God, there's never been a deal like that. There's never been a job like that. There's never been a car deal or a house deal or a property deal or any kind of business. There's never been no kind of deal that's ever been offered in this whole history of mankind than the grace of God through the blood of Yeshua HaMashiach. There's never been a better deal than that. You'll never find anything better than the offer of eternal life in heaven with God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. With all the treasures of heaven upon you, spending eternity with the creator of the universe as one of his children, walking with God in the cool of the day, eating all the luscious fruits, all those things that are a million times better than anything on earth, with no sickness, no disease, no sorrow, no pain, every tear wiped away. Hallelujah. That all those wrongs will be set right, that all the judgments will be fulfilled. hallelujah, that righteousness will exalt and deliver God's people, hallelujah. There'll be no wars, no rumors of wars, no famines, no pestilences, no earthquakes, no sickness and disease, no fighting, no arguing, no fussing. Hallelujah, hallelujah, peace. Peace, wonderful peace, hallelujah. This over in the glory land, in Beulah land, hallelujah. We're going to Beulah land. That's a Bible word that means married. Hallelujah, because the bride will be there married to the Lord. We'll be in Beulah land. Hallelujah, blessed be his holy name. Blessed be his righteous name. Hallelujah, seated on his throne. It must be a big throne, hallelujah. They will be seated on the throne with the Lord, the Bible says. Hallelujah, we overcome and make it there. We will be seated with him on his throne. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You know, that's what I've said when I first read the Bible and got right with God and came back to the Lord in the year 2000 when I started reading the Bible and all that. I said, you know what, Lord, my reward, Lord, if I could just be near you in heaven. In my imagination, I imagine that, you know, the less things you did or the least rewards that you have, it's like the further away you are from Jesus. You know, you're in heaven, but you're like, you know, on the other side of town, you know, from where the Lord is. And I just imagine and say, Lord, the reward I want is just to be, you know, near you, to be able to be near you in heaven, to walk with you in the cool of the day, just to see you, Lord. If I can just see you there, you know, even if you're talking to other people and all that, I'm just going to be looking at you and observing you, Lord. That's all I want, to see my Lord Jesus Christ. That's my greatest desire on this earth, to see the Lord Jesus Christ. You know, and if I could talk to him, that would be even greater. You know, to speak with him, to touch the hem of his garment and all those things, brothers and sisters. That's what it's all about. You don't want to know about the anointing, being filled with the Holy Spirit and all that. Your one heart's desire has got to be for Jesus, to get a hold of Jesus, to lay hold of him. You know, people that used to rip the clothes off of Elvis and all these human idols, stars, you know, they call them stars too, movie stars, rock stars. There's no coincidence that they call them stars. And like that, stars represent angels, fallen angels and holy angels. People are elevating them to like an angel, to worship them, to make an idol out of them, to give them supernatural power, movie stars and rock stars. Fallen angels, brothers and sisters. But we have the one star, the bright and morning star, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. He is worthy to be praised and adored. Hallelujah. Let's lift up holy hands in one accord, singing, blessed be the name, blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. He is worthy to be praised and adored. Hallelujah. Blessed be his name. Honor and glory and power belong to him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. I thank you, Father, that you've hidden all these things from the wise and prudent, but revealed them unto babes. Hallelujah. Fear not, little flock, for it's the Father's good pleasure to give the kingdom to such as us, his flock, his little flock. Blessed be the name of the Lord. He is the good shepherd. Hallelujah. He is worthy to be praised and adored. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He will set us upon a rock. Hallelujah. He'll prepare a table for us in the presence of our enemies. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In his tabernacle, he will hide us. Hallelujah. I'm just speaking two different psalms. This, as the Lord is leading me at Psalm, the 23rd Psalm and the 27th Psalm. As I'm interweaving them, as the Lord is leading me. Praise be to God, Most High, Creator of heaven and earth. El Elyon, the Most High God. Blessed be his name. God is my salvation. Hallelujah. And in him there is no shadow of turning, no darkness nor shadow of turning. Hallelujah. There is God casts no shadow. Hallelujah. For he is pure light, pure love, pure joy, pure wisdom, pure holiness, pure righteousness. Praise be our God. Hallelujah. Brothers and sisters, I could go on and on because I can't tell you how much I love the Lord. I can't put it in words how much he is worthy to be praised and adored, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Get a hold of Jesus. He's passing by. You got to grab the hem of his garment. You got to go after him. That's what he wants us to do. Seek and ye shall find. Knock and it'll be open to you. Ask and you shall receive. Seek, ask, and knock, and keep on going for it. Keep pressing in. Keep pressing in. Don't give up. Just like I told you in the video yesterday, Jacob was wrestling with the angel of the Lord Jesus, before he came to earth, a Christophany. He was wrestling with him, and the Lord said, let go of me. And Jacob said, I'm not going to let go of you till you bless me. He would, you know, he was tenacious. Anything bad you can think of, Jacob had lots of bad traits. But God saw that in him. That's why God chose him. God saw that in him. Like his brother Esau sold his birthright for a bowl of lentil soup. You know, but Jacob, even though he had all kinds of mistakes, just like me and you, I mean, I'm a sinner. But I've got something in me that the Lord saw, that the Lord foreknew that I would do that he wanted, that it pleased him. So he said, hey, Patrick will say yes to A, B, and C, and therefore I've called him and predestined him to do A, B, and C, because I know that's in his heart. I know that's in there. Same with you. There's something in you that the Lord saw from the foundation of the Word. He said, hey, this person right here, this child of mine, I know this person's going to be a Christian. I know this person's going to say yes to me to do A, B, and C. And I know they're going to do these sins, and I know they're going to repent, and I'm going to forgive them, and they're going to make it. They're going to make it into my kingdom. The Lord already knows that. He already knew every sin you were going to do, and he knew you were going to repent or not. He knew you were going to get saved or not. He knew that he could count on you and use you for his glory in A, B, C, D, but not in E. He knows what we can and can't do and what we will and won't do already, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. But you don't know and I don't know. That's the whole thing. Hallelujah. Go find out. Seek the Lord. Get a hold of him. And then he will show you what to do. God bless you guys. I'll see you guys later. God bless.